Push for Legalization co-founder and executive chair Ronan Levy joins us now alongside special advisor and former Senate Majority Leader Tom Daschle. Good morning, I should say, to both of you. Thanks for being with us. Leader Daschle, I'll start with you. I mean, I realize microdosing is all the rage right now, but as a club kid myself of the 90s, a raver of the 90s, call me skeptical. I lay out the science and the case that you are making for legalization of psychedelics and why this is an opportunity for investors.
Well, there's a real paradigm shift that is underway right now with regard to the research and the science. People are becoming a lot more aware of the capacity for psychedelics to address many of the challenges we face in health, especially on mental health. They're looking at these molecules in a new way and fully appreciate that a lot more science, a lot more research needs to be done. But all of the evidence so far is extremely promising, and Field Trip is leading the effort to accomplish this new appreciation of what we can do with regard to addressing the many challenges we face in mental health today.
So, Ronan, when we talk about Field Trip leading the effort, what do those efforts involve, and what specific types of psychedelics are we talking about?
The specific types of drugs we're talking about right now, the focus has been on psilocybin, which is the active ingredient in magic mushrooms in terms of the street names, MDMA, which is ecstasy. If you're a raver kid, you would probably be familiar with that, as well as a number of other molecules such as DMT, LSD, as well as the next generation of molecules, which is what we're working on. So Field Trip has two divisions. One is our Field Trip Discovery division, which is focusing on the next generation of psychedelic molecules. The current research, the classic psychedelics, they show incredible promise and efficacy. It doesn't mean that they can't be improved on, and there's a number of ways that we believe we can improve on psilocybin in particular. FT-104, our first molecule, is very psilocybin-like, but it shrinks the duration, which lowers the cost and lowers the barriers to access, which is incredibly important when we're talking about the psychedelic therapies. On the other side of the equation, we have our Field Trip Health division, which is developing and building out the clinical infrastructure to deliver these kinds of therapies. Because what's unique about psychedelics is that it's not conventional pharma or biotech. It is experiential medicine, which means the actual experience around the drug session is as important as the drug itself. So it's a really unique area of medicine that's evolving right now.
Leader Daschle, like Morgan, I was more of a stoner, I guess, than a raver. But given everything, and obviously we've had you on many times in terms of supporting the legalization of cannabis nationwide. I mean, where are we headed as a country here? We seem to have a mental health crisis, and we seem to are going to have a availability of a lot of different things to sort of numb people to some extent, at least some critics might say.
Well, I think we are recovering, really, from a lot of misinformation that occurred for decades, even generations, around these therapies in the past. We made a lot of assumptions that just haven't borne out. And as we learn more, as science is applied, as we begin to appreciate the tremendous opportunities here that exist, especially on the mental health side, both on the cannabis as well as for psychedelics, I'm very excited about the future and what it can bring. Obviously, it's going to take more research, more changes in public policy, but I'm confident that that will occur over the